we have developed with the Long-Wave Infrared Supercontinuum Laser is combining best of both worlds in one laser system. Essentially, we have the beam quality and brightness of lasers, while we have the bandwidth and spectral coverage of glow bars and lamps. My name is Reza Salem. I'm the manager for the fiber laser group at Thorlabs. The Long-Wave Infrared Supercontinuum Laser is a broadband laser source. Covers a very important part of the optical spectrum. It's called the molecular fingerprint region. That's where most compounds and chemicals have their signature that they can be detected in that region. But in terms of the laser system, really the key differentiator from some of the competition that's out there is the fact that we've developed this entire system based on a fiber laser platform that is extremely robust and compact. So it really allows the system to be portable and deployable to different settings and environments. Additionally, the architecture is based on femtosecond laser pulses, and this is known to have high temporal coherence, which leads to very low noise. So you can really perform highly sensitive measurements using this laser system.
I'm Ankita Khanolkar, and currently I'm working as fiber lasers product development engineer at Thorlabs. And my responsibility was to convert a laboratory breadboard setup into a commercial product. That involved rigorous experimentation phase to define product specs. We developed multiple prototypes, built those, tested those to arrive at the final product design.
One of the important tools that we used in our work was Thorlabs' optical spectrum analyzer, which was also developed for the same part of the spectral region. And this tool allows us to be able to look at the signal as we develop the concept from proof of concept to product and be able to look at the output spectrum and see what we're getting out of the laser.
I also collaborated with highly cross-functional team of mechanical, electrical, software, firmware engineers because all our lasers are integrated systems. So the vertical integration that was involved in LWIRSC product development was fluoride fiber that is manufactured by Thorlabs Advanced Photonics. We also have gained knowledge about splicing the fluoride fiber from Thorlabs Vitron division. And we have experts that can design this fiber suitable to our needs. And this fiber played a crucial role in the pump of LWIRSC.
So we saw a customer that wanted a new performance coming out of the laser system that was important to them. So that really drove us to tackle the big challenge of developing this laser. So the Long-Wave Supercontinuum Laser has far-reaching applications. And really what it comes down to is the fact that the molecular fingerprint region allows detection of all kinds of molecules. If they could be solids, liquids, or gases. So people can actually use a Long-Wave Supercontinuum Laser to send light over a long path in the atmosphere and see what gases are released in the atmosphere. So this could be used for environmental applications, for example, in the landfill to detect chemicals that are toxic or are harmful to humans. Or it could be used in an oil and gas field to detect methane leaks. Or it could be simply used to detect methane levels for environmental and sustainability applications.
So traditional plastic sorting requires you to identify different types of plastic. And traditional methods are very complex. Each type of plastic has a characteristic absorption signature that falls in this molecular fingerprint region. LWIRSC, combined with spectroscopic methods, will help to form smart mass recycling methods.
On the other hand, you can look at different solids and liquids in the mid-infrared and detect them. This could be used in pharmaceutical and food industry, for life sciences, for example, detecting skin cancer cells. Standoff detection, so it could be used for defense applications, for detecting targets that are far away. Because the laser has such a good beam quality, it allows propagation over long distances. Infrared microscopy could be impacted by this laser. It could also impact hyperspectral imaging in larger scales. For example, looking at the surface of the Earth, it could really develop new companies for new types of instruments out there that could use this laser, and it could really be a driver behind new ideas that could, you know, then come to the market a few years from now.